Jack Dorsey announcing today that Twitter will no longer accept political ads in advance of a 2020 election. Dorsey tweeting this, "We've made the decision to stop all political advertising on Twitter globally. We believe political message reach should be earned, not bought." That is in stark contrast to Facebook's hands-off policy of not fact-checking political ads. So let's discuss. Josh Green is here, Mark McKinnon. Short time, a lot to discuss, guys. Thank you so much. Josh, Trump 2020 campaign manager Brad Parscale seems to think that there's bias in the new policy, tweeting this, "Twitter bans political ads and yet another attempt by the left to silence Trump and conservatives. I wouldn't be surprised if Twitter lifted the ban after 2020. The ban applies to everyone, so where's the problem?"
There is no problem. He saw bias in the old policy. Now he sees bias in the news policy. Parscale and conservatives generally, I think, have been very effective at working the refs, at putting pressure on social media companies like Facebook and Twitter, get them to bend over backwards to allow conservatives to do things that if they stopped and thought about it, they might not. And I think that's why Dorsey made this decision. I think it's why it's a good decision. Political ads don't bring in a lot of money. As we've seen from Zuckerberg, they bring big headaches, and this is a way of stepping out and saying, you know what, I'm not going to get my company involved in this.
Yeah. Mark, you headed up advertising for three presidential campaigns. You also went to jail in defense of free speech as a newspaper editor. Is the best way to deal with the fake claims in political ads not to run them at all?
No, it's not. I mean, here we have two alternatives. There's a third way, which is to do what most broadcast stations and other responsible platforms do, which is they take a look at the content, they determine whether or not it's factual, and it's not factual, like when we did campaigns in the old days, they'd send it back to us and say, fix it. So there's got to be some responsibility and some accountability. Mark Zuckerberg is saying, we have no accountability. Mm-hmm. And then on the other hand, we have Twitter saying, we're not even going to play the game. And by the way, let's be honest about this, they're only losing $3 million in revenue. So this is more of a market game, I think, about positioning against Facebook than it is about. But it's an interesting position that they've taken. But the real responsible position is in the middle, to accept the content, mm-hmm. but accept the content that is only factual.
Yeah, it's interesting, especially now when people are having trouble trying to figure out what's real and what's not, because there's so much fake news out there and so many bots and what have you, and fake ads.
Well, the reason there's so much fake news, Don, is because nobody's willing to stand up and say this is a fact and this isn't. That's what we've got to do. We've got to have accountability at the platforms to say we have to be the referees. Somebody's got to do it. And if there's no referees, then it's just complete Wild West. Mm-hmm. And we have Russians and others taking control of the platforms. Mm-hmm.
Good answer. Josh, listen, just today, Zuckerberg double down on Facebook's political ad policy. Didn't address Twitter directly, but said, we need to be careful about adopting more and more rules. In a democracy, I don't think it is right for private companies to censor politicians or the news. According to Zuckerberg, political advertising will account for less than 0.5% of next year's quarterly ad revenue. Does the risk-reward scenario, make sense for them?
No, not at all. I mean, look at the reputational damage this has done to Facebook already. There are very few things that Republicans and Democrats in Washington can agree on, but most of them agree that Facebook and social media platforms are doing a terrible job and are a problem. And you've had Republicans working the refs. You've now had Joe Biden come out, Elizabeth Warren come out and call Facebook a disinformation for profit racket. This is going to present at some point not just reputational problems, but regulatory problems when some of these people get power and decide, well, maybe we need to regulate Facebook a little tighter if Zuckerberg himself won't do it. So it is baffling and inexplicable to me why you would put up with these kind of headaches for, as Mark pointed out, such a small amount of profit. The risk reward just doesn't seem worth it.
Mark, do you think they'll change? I got 10 seconds. Do you think that Facebook will change? They'll be forced to? Because I don't see why everybody else can be regulated, even us as a broadcast, and they don't have to.
I think they're going to take it to the wall. I think their plan is that they don't want any censorship. They don't want any accountability. And that's the design of the thing. That's why Zuckerberg has doubled down on it. Yeah. No accountability. That's the way they got where they are, and that's the way they want to go.